I recently made a video about how to farm cinder shards in Stardew Valley, and I got quite a few comments about how quite a few people haven't made it to level 10 in the volcano yet and unlocked the forge. So I thought I'd quickly make a video on how to easily get from floor 1 to floor 10 as quickly as possible with a couple simple rules. I can't use anything that you can only get at the forge, for example, I can't use combined rings or any overpowered infinity weapons. Otherwise, everything else is fair game. Alrighty, let's get started. For the first tip, you should zoom out so that you can see more of each floor and help reduce any surprises. I actually don't like playing when the game is fully zoomed out, but I did it just for this challenge and already changed it back to normal. Playing zoomed out really does make a difference. You should also drink some triple shot espresso and eat some spicy eel. They both give a speed buff and they do stack. This makes you fast enough to be able to dodge most enemies and outrun magma sprites with ease. The only time I think I got hit was when I had to hit rocks in my way or when I had to navigate around and hit switches to open doors. Anyone can get triple shot espresso. You can buy the recipe at the Stardrop Saloon for 5,000 gold. Then you can buy coffee from the Stardrop Saloon and turn the regular coffee into triple shot espresso at the stove in your kitchen. You can use regular coffee, but I prefer to use triple shot espresso because it lasts longer and then I don't have to worry about my speed buff running out during the run. Spicy eel is something that anyone that has unlocked Ginger Island should be able to obtain. Simply duplicate some rubies using the Crystallarium and then trade the rubies for some spicy eel at the Desert Trader. It's really easy and definitely worth it. You will get a speed boost and a luck boost. If your goal is just to reach level 10 in the volcano and unlock the shortcut for later, you should just focus on getting straight to the floor exit and reaching the next floor. Ignore the enemies, you will be running so fast you can easily outrun and dodge them. To save you extra time, only hit the absolutely necessary rocks that are blocking your way. I know it can be very tempting and hard to just run past some iridium or cinder shard nodes, but we gotta go fast here. There is one more tip that will help you a ton if you are struggling. The volcano is unique and has an interesting way of rendering into the game. Every single day, the volcano will render to a specific layout, and that layout will stay exactly the same if you quit the game and log back in. This means that you can enter the volcano, learn the floor layouts, and then quit and re-enter the game. When you go back into the volcano, the layouts will be exactly the same. This will help you quite a bit because you will instinctively know where you can expect the exits on the floor that you have visited before. You'll see that I do make quite a few mistakes in this run by blocking for no reason, taking the wrong path, and I completely skipped a switch on floor 8 somehow, which cost me like 20 seconds, but it is what it is. You really can get to the end of the volcano extremely quickly if you wanted to. If the RNG gods are on your side and you get extremely lucky with layouts and rock placements, I think you can get a sub 2-minute time. I mean, if there's a mushroom floor, that would already cut down the time by quite a bit because those floors are so short. I ended up with a very impressive 3 minutes and 20 seconds. I think I could have done it a bit faster, maybe even sub 3 minutes, but this is not too bad. I won't lie, when I was trying this, I had an insane amount of fun. I would highly recommend you guys give this a try. Boot up your save file and try to power through the volcano as fast as you can. You don't need to download the timer like I did, but if you do time your runs, please come back to this video and drop your times in the comments below. I want to see how fast someone can actually get to floor 10 in the volcano. It might be something insane. I know the shortest possible time is definitely much less than my attempt. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to absolutely smash that subscribe button. I release tons of Stardew Valley videos and you don't want to miss my next video. Anyway, see you in the next video.